Our next guest narrowly escaped persecution in Egypt to go on to become one of the leading musicians in the world. Now with a rare ARIA hat trick under his belt and an 11th album released, he joins us here on Studio 10. Please welcome Joseph Tawadros.
Hey, buddy.
How are you?
Hi,
what's going on?
Welcome.
Love and life. What, how are you doing?
I mean, it's Movember.
Hugh Jackman, man. Hugh Jackman. I didn't quite get the audition, so what can we do? Hey.
I would have given you the part with a look like that.
What can you do?
Fantastic work. Congratulations.
Thanks so much.
Plugging away for a while.
Plugging away, yeah.
Finally get recognised.
Yeah, oh, it's good. I mean, you know, it's a beautiful... I'm very lucky, you know, to be able to do what I do. And it's all icing on the cake sort of stuff. I'm very happy to be playing the oud, which no one knows about, which is great. So hopefully we'll change that today.
I think today is about, you know, sharing the oud with the world.
I mean, it's oud awareness week starting today, by the way.
Well, you've got to take the starting oud with that. The dad.
That's okay.
But can you tell us a little bit about, like, what's your background? Your parents are musicians or, like, what's your story?
Yeah, well, I was born in Egypt, a Coptic background, so the Christian Egyptians, and we came here, immigrated here in 1986, and, yeah, my parents just loved music, and my grandfather played the oud, and, you know, I just loved it, and it was kind of a link between my heritage and now I kind of, what I do with it is kind of a link between Australia and the Middle East in a way.
And the oud is it like a guitar or what is it?
It's a lute, basically. It's the ancestor of the lute. Actually, the word lute comes from the word al-oud, so al-oud, lute and so forth. So that's how it's come about.
Is this an instrument that's played a lot in Egypt?
Yeah, well, the Middle East, it's actually the most popular instrument in the Middle East. It's called the king of all instruments. That's how it's known. So that's pretty... you can't beat that. Once you get king of all instruments, you get lesser instruments. That's it. I mean, that's what you've got to do.
And how do you... I mean, it's very hard to break into the music industry at the best of times, let alone when you're playing music that would be completely unfamiliar to...
Have I broken?
Most
I'm not
audience.
Sure. I've broken in yet. I'm working on it.
I think you're getting there, but how's it been... How have you gone about it and how's it
been
received?
It's really quite incredible. I mean, you know, sometimes I'm in situations where I go, how in the world did I get here? And it's all because of the oud. Like last year, Mick Jagger came to one of my concerts in India. And I was looking there and I was going, well, how in the world did this happen?
Yeah, but you're being really modest. You're really a world player of the oud,
thanks,
aren't you?
Ida. You're so sweet. I mean, that's so lovely.
You've got a fantastic musical reputation.
Yeah, it's been good. I must say it's been good. But, you know, I've been very lucky and very blessed. And I think that's the good thing. You kind of do things with intention. I've, you know, kept on chugging along, even though it is a bit of a hard road. And, you know, you keep on chugging along, but with the right intention. And you know, it's great to be recognised.
Three arias in 3 years?
Yeah, not bad.
What's next?
So 4 arias in 4 years. That's what I'm doing. No, I'm trying to actually start an Arabic boy band called 5 Seconds of Osama. So we'll see how that works. I mean, that's kind of...
Tell us about this. I love the title, Permission to Evaporate. Tell us what you mean by that.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes I'm stuck in situations going, yeah, I've got to get out of here. So that's basically...
Is this one of them?
No, Permission to Stay is the sequel. But no, it was actually a really tough time. I guess my parents passed away in the last 2 years, so my mother and my father. And so sometimes you get these moments where you just need to get sort of out of your world, but there's so much that ties you down. And so that's the message behind the album, is there's sometimes you just need to break out, but there's so much that ties you to your world. But it was a really great experience recording the album. We went to New York and recorded with two of the greatest. My brother's also a percussionist, and we had the great pianist Matt McMahon.
Wow.
My brother being James Tawadros, and two great legends of the jazz world, one being one of the greatest double bass players, Christian McBride, who was doing shows with James Brown and things like that, and Mike Stern, who was playing with Miles Davis in his band. So we were very lucky to get those guys to be excited about the project, and really we had a great time in the studio and finished it in 2 days and got the ARIA.
Good on you.
Thank you so much for joining us. The power of music. It's a wonderful thing. And good luck at the ARIAs. And the ARIAs are broadcast here on Network 10 tomorrow night. There is still plenty more in this edition of Studio 10. And stand by that phone. You could be playing What's in the Box when we come back.